Hey guys, it's Xavier Kelly. In this video right here, I'm gonna give you the top 5 Taboola features that you guys need to be using. So make sure you stay tuned and learn more about it. So for you guys who are out there who don't know much about Taboola is a native discovery ad platform that allows you basically to be able to put display ads next to relevant content. It's very amazing. Taboola is reaching 95% of the people in the United States that are online, and also is getting over 1 billion clicks globally and reaching over 1 billion people as well. So it's a huge platform. You can do a lot of stuff on here, and it's more of an offensive approach than using like Google AdWords or any of those search engine AdWords, anything like Bing ads, anything like that. It's more discovery platform. So basically I want to talk to you guys about the top 5 features that you guys just aren't using right now. And these features are problems that I see pop up in emails I get from you guys and comments, and it's the reason why your campaigns sometimes aren't performing as well as it should be. So the first one is going to be audiences. Audiences are basically going to be everything you go to, from deciding on what audience you're actually targeting, and you're going to go more in detail into the actual specific people. And so Taboola has done some interesting cool things lately. They basically have made it so that you can almost do what you do on like YouTube when you're doing advertisements. So you can actually pick people out in a certain industry or looking for us over a certain genre, because they're starting to just group together the actual content. And a couple of those places that I really, one of the actual couple features that inside the audience that I really like and think you should be using, or at least testing, is the marketplace audiences. Taboola has put together a list of, basically you can go through of more of your geographics, from like your males to female to what percentage of actually income they make, to exactly into like what actually they might do and what content they might care about. So you can do that now inside the platform, which is amazing. So you can be able to segment more. So if you are advertising something that is specifically for men or for women, or something that is more pricey and more luxury items that are meant to be for people who have more money, then that's literally the best way to go by doing it right there. Another one too as well, if you already have run some ads and you got some people to click, and those people have done some action or read the article you've seen, you can actually get those people to come back, and you can show ads specifically just to those people. This is called campaign clickers. You choose what campaigns you had, and then it'll go through and advertise to those clickers. So the good thing is, if you have like a huge awareness campaign that you're running on Taboola, so people can know more about you, they want to do something more targeted to the people who actually engaged in your actual business and actually, or your content or whatever you were putting out, then that is the perfect way to go by through there. I wouldn't run specifically both of these campaigns, market audiences and campaign clickers, at the same time, but I would run them separately and see how they help you improve whatever campaign you're running now. So basically, I would take my campaign, I would duplicate it, and then I would add in one of these two features to see exactly how to compare to my regular campaign. Number 2, we're gonna dive way deeper into campaign clicker. I know I talk about a little bit audience, I'm gonna pull this out even more for you guys. So if you guys have used Google AdWords retargeting or retargeting at all, basically campaign clickers is exactly the same as that right there. Only thing, it's right, you don't have to do much from that. Basically, you don't have any pixels or anything on the page, and Taboola has all that for you already set up. Basically, you choose what campaigns you want, as I said before in the last section. Make sure these should be really good for choosing from awareness campaigns, and you do more direct sales on these right here. That's the best way to do it. So if you have basically have your brand, and your brand sells water, let's say that right here, and you've heard a video over how precious water is or something like that, you will use that in your awareness campaign to push out people, and the people who click on that ad will actually be put into that group right there. And then you have another campaign running that allows you to be able to target those people who clicked that and actually went through and read that content. And then from there, you can go in and show them specific content that's more detailed. And you can see, you can funnel your way down into actually getting those people to actually purchase something. Very interesting. It's very well done. Something you couldn't really do on Taboola for a long period of time. And now you can do that. You can add the pixel on there, and you can be able to track your conversions, and you can really, really, really be able to see exactly how everything is working and target down, which, a long time ago, that was an issue with Taboola or Outbrain. But now they're really working on getting the targeting down, so you are able to actually go through and and make more sales, make more targeted approaches like that, and do a lot more, similar to how YouTube does on their discovery platform as well. 3, platforms. And I really want to spread this right here. there's only a small amount of ads you should run across every single platform. And those, all those ads should be probably awareness campaign in the awareness stage of creating your campaign. So make sure you guys don't run across all of them, but let's go through the three. So they have desktops, we have mobile phones, and we have tablets. And so each one of these are very specific and I will use for certain things. So if I am marketing or trying to get downloads from my free mobile app or my paid mobile app, I would do it only on mobile phones. I would not be spending time sending people from their desktop to a mobile application that they can't even open or actually download. And if you realize that, if you do that, you end up losing a lot of conversions. So if any of you guys who are using mobile applications at all, you know, and trying to demarket them, if you're running on desktop or you're running on tablet and then that app can't be downloaded on tablet or so, then it won't work out for you. You're basically gonna waste all that traffic that you're going through and doing. The next one, tablets. So if you are making applications specifically for tablets, or you're making content, or you're creating content that people can view pretty nicely on a tablet, and you have a nice layout and everything like that for a mobile-friendly layout, then tablets, that's a good portion to work on right there. And you can do that. And maybe you're trying to get people who are using casually reading. A lot of people read a lot of stuff on their tablets. So that's a good way to go by. The last one is desktop. So basically, if you are selling software that is supposed to be installed on basically a Mac or Windows or any of the other platforms out there like Linux, then you need to be only marketing people who are going through and using desktop. Because if they're not on a desktop, they're not gonna be able to download the software. And so basically you just get a wasted click, similar to the mobile app portion, where if the person is going through and you're marketing a mobile app and they're on a desktop, they're not gonna be able to download it. So you waste money, waste clicks. And that happens a lot of time to people, especially for people who actually have where you download something. So if you even have like a guide or something too, well, any of that stuff right there, software, anything that needs to be downloaded, and specifically the platform, make sure that what you're sending them to is very, very set up for each platform. And if I was you, I would separate my platforms. If I'm doing an awareness campaign, I would do one more, for something different mobile. It have a different viewing experience, it'll look different. My stuff for tablets could be similar to my mobile experience, but I would have it scaled up. And then for my actual desktop, it'd be a different experience. So you can still run your campaigns, but separate them by your actual platforms as well. Number four, when are your campaigns running? Make sure you set your campaign schedule to the right time. This is huge. If you are doing something and you're selling straight to B2B business, and this is mid to small to mid-sized businesses and people like that, then you really don't need to have your ads running all over the weekend, except if you have some type of data that shows that it works well and it actually runs on that time. Because then you might have problems where people won't be able to be clicking it, or the wrong people will be clicking it. And like, what times do your people actually get online? Now, if you are doing some entrepreneurs, they might have more time on the weekend. They might actually go enjoy that content more on the weekends. They might do it on the afternoon after we're not working and stuff like that. So those are really, really big things you need to really look into when you actually deciding on a campaign on schedule. Basically, what time do they work? When are they online? And then like, when are they most likely to click your ads? But basically what I would try to do is that I would really go through and then I would tag every single campaign that I put out there, just with like the Google tag and like just with the parameters at the end of it. I would tag each one, so when I go back to my Google Analytics, I can see exactly what time people were clicking on these ads. Because then the more clicks and based on your conversions, you're gonna decide on if you need to open it up 24 hours, you need to open just during work time, do you need to do it from noon to midnight? You can figure out better time so you're not wasting clicks and you're not getting people clicking who are not gonna take action because they're not your targeted users. And that's like the biggest thing that hurts people, is that if they have ads running at the wrong times and really targeting the wrong people. Five, not using the operating system targeting. So if you are a software developer or you are anything on that lines that the person might need to download something that's more specific, then if you are advertising Windows software to someone who's on a mobile Android phone, then it's not gonna work. You basically are just throwing away money and stuff like that. People might say, oh, this is an interesting idea, but when they get to the page and they realize that they can't download anything, it doesn't work out. So one thing I would really look into doing is going through and making sure if I'm doing anything software related, if I'm doing like a mobile app, or if I have something that's more specific to actually that platform. Like if I'm doing like a Windows 10 tips. I'm not gonna be giving it to people who are on Android or trying to give it to people who are using Mac OS. I'm gonna only specifically target and track those people who are actually a Windows operating system who have that. So you really need to use that right there. This right here will help you kind of avoid sending your content out to people who actually won't be able to use it or really care about it because they're not using the same systems that you are using or that you are targeting. That's a really big component right there, especially for app developers, software developers, more tech content and stuff like that, that are over certain browsers. You're basically pushing stuff out, but you're wasting clicks because these people are going to your actual article and realizing, or clicking your article and then realizing at the end, like, oh, this is not what I wanted. So you want people to be able to clearly understand what you're trying to push out, and you want to be able to deter any clicks that you do not want from your text and your actual image. And then just to make it a lot easier on yourself so that you spend less money, and two, you get more targeted and you get more conversions. So much for watching this video. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and that, and also too, comment down below on if these tips are helpful, and also what ways are you guys going out and using Taboola ads. I would love to know, just to understand exactly how you guys are using it, and so I can make other videos that are more related to what you guys are doing. And maybe we might do some Taboola actual I might go through your accounts and actually help you organize it and do some reviews that way too as well. So if you want that, please comment down below and just say review, and then I'll send you basically a message and we'll set something up, and maybe I'll review you on the channel for one of the videos so you can be able to create a better ad campaigns. And also too, guys, I want to say, guys, again, thank you guys for stopping by and watching. I really appreciate you guys. Basically took a little break right there and hurting my shoulder a little bit, but that's all fixed up right now. And now we're going to get back and do a lot more content. And I'm basically going to choose the content based off what you guys have been watching the most on and what you have been engaging the most on. One thing I do want to say, guys, is that if you guys are using Taboola, make sure you drop a comment down below and let me know. And let me know if you like this video on top of that so I can be able to create more content like this. But guys, thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, again, go in and subscribe. And I'm Xavier Kelly, and I'll see you in the next one.